How are you everybody? How are you today? This is the lecture number 11 in our course Mathematical Statistical Model in Econometrics. This is for 4th year Statistics English section Benha University. This lecture is a summarization about what we stated in the previous lectures. And this lecture is very important, and I want from every student to study this lecture very closely and understand and make differences between economic and economic models and models and many important aspects related to econometrics. Important econometrics aspects, part one. This lecture is related to what the meaning of economic and econometrics and economic model, because there are some misleading about this aspects related to our lectures and our previous lecture. And I want from every student to understand very closely the differences between the main aspects of econometrics. Welcome. Who uses econometrics? Econometrics is important. It is used constantly in business, in finance, in economics, in government, in consulting, and in many other aspects, many other fields. Econometric models are used routinely for tasks ranging from data description to policy analysis, and ultimately they guide many important decisions. To develop a feel for the tenuous diversity of econometric application, let us explore some of the areas where they feature prominently and the corresponding diversity of decisions supported. One key field is economics, of course, broadly defined. Governments, business, policy organizations, central banks, financial services firms, and economic consulting firms around the world routinely use econometrics. Governments, central banks, and policy organizations use econometric models to guide monetary policy, fiscal policy, and as well as education and training, health and transfer policies. And in many other fields uses econometrics. Business use econometrics for strategic planning tasks. This include management strategy of all types, including operations management and control, hiring, production, inventory, investment, marketing, pricing, distributing, advertising, accounting, budgeting, review, revenues and expenditure, and so on. Sales modeling is a good example. Firms routinely use econometric models of sales to help guide management decision in inventory management, sales force management, production planning, and new market entry. More generally, business firms use econometric models to help decide what to provide, what product or mix of products should be produced, how when to produce, should we build up inventories now in anticipation of high future demand, how many shifts should be run, how much to produce and how much capacity to build, what are the trends in the market size and market share, are there cyclical or seasonal effects, how quickly and with what pattern will a newly built brand or newly installed technology and where to produce, should we have one plant or many plants, if many, where should we locate them. Okay, firms also use forecasts of future prices and availability of inputs to guide production decisions. This is many aspects related to econometrics. Econometrics models are also critical in financial services, including assets management, assets pricing, mergers and acquisitions, investment banking and insurance. Portfolio managers, for example, are keenly interested in the empirical modeling and understanding of assets returns, stocks, bonds, exchange rates, commodity price. Econometrics is similarly central to financial risk management in recent decades. Econometric methods for volatility modeling have been developed and widely applied to evaluate and ensure risks associated with assets portfolios and to price assets such as options and other derivatives. Finally, econometrics is central to the work of a wide variety of consulting firms, mainly of which support the business functions already mentioned. For example, is also a very action area in which econometric models are routinely used for damage assessment, lot earnings, but for analysis and so on. Now, what distinguishes econometrics? Econometrics is much more than just statistics using economic data, although it is of course very closely related to statistics. Again, econometrics is much more than, is greater than just a statistic using economic data. Although it is of course very closely related to statistics, there is a strong relation between statistics and econometrics. Econometrics has a special focus on prediction and forecasting. In many respects, the goal of econometrics is to help agents, firms, organizations, consumers, firms, inventories, policymakers make better decisions, and the good forecasts are key input to good decisions. So that there is a good relation between economics and statistics. Econometrics must confront the special issues and features that arise routinely in economic data, such as trends, seasons, and cycles. Econometrics must confront the special problem arising due to its largely non-experimental nature. Model, misspecification, structure, charge, and etc. Important econometrics aspects, part 1. This lecture is related to what the meaning of economic and econometrics and economic model, because there are some misleading about these aspects related to our lectures and our previous lectures. And I want from every student to understand very closely the differences between the main aspects of econometrics. Another issue is whether the data are recorded over time, over space, or some combination of the two. Time series data are recorded over time, as for example with the US GDP gross domestic product, which is measured once per quarter. A gross domestic product GDP data set might contain quarterly data for say 1096 to the percent. Cross-sectional data, in contrast, are recorded over space at a point in time, as with yesterday's closing stock price for each of the U.S. Okay. The data structure can be blended, as for example, with a time series of cross-section. If, moreover, the cross-sectional units are identical over time, we speak of panel data or logarithmic data. An example would be the daily closing stock price of each of the US firms recorded over each of the last 30 days. Thank you for everybody. See you in the next lecture in the faculty and on the faculty website. Thank you for everybody.